shit is crazy. Anyways, what is good, y'all? Look, listen, we gotta get right back into Doki Doki. I know it's been a while. I just been having helly homework to do, y'all. And I really hope y'all can hear me over the game, cause I know the game is a little loud. But golly, these beats go crazy. We gonna get right back into it. I know last time we was writing poems and da 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 blah blah blah. Little girl had me pause for us. Homegirl had me buttoned up her shirt, looking at them things. Let's keep doing what we was doing. I hope y'all stick around for this, cause I really enjoy this game. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. Alright, we hopping right back where we left off at. I'ma leave the camera down here so y'all can see better. Whenever I'm reading and shit, y'all can see the people on the picture better. Yeah, see, that's better. Well, it's about what I expected from someone like you. Golly, bitch, that's kinda rude. Well, excuse me. It's not like I said it was bad or anything. Man. It just didn't evoke any emotions. Damn, she hated. Damn, she gonna smack me? Well, anyways, I guess I need to show you mine. Not that you'll like it. I mean, eagles can fly, monkeys can climb, crickets. So you're telling me she was just bashing on my... On my poem, and this is what she wrote? If they give me the option, bro, I'm talking about her poem dirty. I think it is a lie. I do not like it. Why are you so convinced that I wouldn't like it? Well, man, I wouldn't take that writing seriously either, my boy. I ain't gonna lie to you. I'm not even gonna lie to you. Your writing style wouldn't make your message any less valid. But I like when it's easy to read, but it hits you hard. That poem, monkeys can fly, waves can move, squirrels can glide. I got big, like, bro, come on, bro. That was not a good poem. Puts more weight on the wordplay. Like, I set up rhyme at the end, but it made it fall flat on purpose. No, it didn't do anything. I don't want to talk to this girl, bro. That poem was so whack. How we start out the video with her bad poem? Come on, Monica, yes sir. Baby girl, I'm having a great time. Shit. Good, I'm glad to hear it. By the way, since you're new and everything, if you ever have any suggestions for the club, like new activities or things we can do better, I'm always listening. Don't be afraid to bring things up, okay? Alright, I'll keep that in mind. Of course I ain't gonna bring nothing up. What? I'm much better off just going with the flow. Anyways, wanna share your poem with me? It's kind of embarrassing, but I guess. Ha ha ha! Don't worry. We're all a little embarrassed today, you know? But that's a sort of barrier that we'll all learn to get past soon. Word. Yeah. I like this one. It makes me think of something Sayori would like. Is that so? You and Sayori are really good friends, right? That's crazy that, like, I didn't even write the poem for Sayori. I wrote it for what was her name? Yuki? Yuji? I don't remember what her name was, but the emo one that looked like Raven. Da 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 da. Hey yo, Monica, let's not talk about her, baby. Let's talk about me and you and the things that we can do, what we can be, what we can see. Come on. Ma'am, let me read your poem. You keep talking about me and homegirl. Let me read yours. There we go. Do you want to read my poem now? Don't worry, it's not very good. Well, that's because I have to sound confident. That doesn't mean I always feel that way, you know? I see. Well, let me read it then, cuz. What They switched it up. They got the bass on the piano. Da-dum-dum, da-dum-dum, da-ding-ding, da-dum-dum, da-dum-ding, da-da-da. Okay, hole in the wall. It couldn't have been me. See? The direction the spackle protrudes? A noisy neighbor? An angry boyfriend? I'll never know. I wasn't home. I peer inside for a clue. No! I can't see. I reel, blind like a film left out in the sun, but it's too late. My retinas, already scorched with a permanent copy of the meaningless image. It's just a little hole, it wasn't too bright. It was too deep, stretching forever into everything. A hole of infinite choices, I realize now that I wasn't looking in, I was looking out, and he, on the other side, was looking in. I don't, for some reason, my bad bro, my arm is itching. I got sunburned. For some reason, this is giving me a creepy vibe. Okay. So, what do you think? It's very freeform, I guess. Not really the right person to ask for feedback. Haha, it's okay. I'm waiting to see like if she says anything like that catches me off guard or weird. Was inspiration? Well, I'm not sure if I know how to put it. I used to say that I had some kind of epiphany recently. An epiphany? Yeah, something like that. Anyways, top right and tip of the day. Okay, if you try hard to make it perfect, you'll never make any progress. Just force yourself to get something down on the paper and tidy it up later. I glanced around the room. That was a little bit more stressful, but y'all know the song? I don't know, but Purple looking at me like she want the wood. Yes sir, y'all know the song. Let me move the camera down a little bit more. Nah, that ain't really it. Anyways, Yuri, my baby. Sorry, y'all. It's like early in the morning right now. I'm Kevin. It's 12 o'clock.
did you say something?
Oh, it's nothing. I guess you could say it's fancy or whatever, my nigga.
Thank you. Yours is, it's cute.
Cute? Did you just completely miss the symbolism or something? It's clearly about the feeling of giving up. How can that be cute? Her poem was not about giving up. Her poem was just BS. Bro, why is she bullying her, bro?
Well, I do have a couple suggestions.
If I was looking for suggestions, I would have asked someone who actually liked it. Which people did, by the way. Sayori liked it. And Izzy did, too. So, based on that, I'll gladly give you some suggestions on my own. First of all, excuse me, bitch, but this was a long time establishing my writing style. Leave me the fuck alone. That's pretty much what she said, honestly. Ooh. Uh-oh.
You're just
maybe just jealous that he appreciates my advice more than he appreciated yours. Huh? How do you know he didn't appreciate my advice more? Are you that full of yourself?
No.
If I was full of myself, I would literally go out of my way, everything go over the QT. These niggas are beefing over me.
What did I tell y'all last video? She won me. She warned me!
What'd I tell y'all? Damn. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Aw, oh, that beat was fire. What did this fucking Banjo-Kazooie ass beat, bro? That's beat, bro. My bad, bro. I'm not reading this. There's a reason we have so many deep expressive words in our language. It's the only way to convey complex feelings and meaning the most effective way. Avoiding them is not only unnecessarily limiting yourself, but it's also a waste. You don't understand that, right? How did I get dragged into this in the first place? It's not like I like anything about writing. But where am I probably thinking more highly than me? Bruh. Yuri, that's my baby. Exactly. Comes something really personal. That's why Natsuki felt threatened. So wait. Okay, there we go. I was about to say, like, whose side am I on? You both did some things that you didn't mean. Yuri apologized. Don't you think you should too? Natsuki, she clenches her face. She's trapped at this point being defiant, only because she can't handle the pressure. I end up feeling bad for her. Sometimes when I'm hurt, it helps me to take a walk and clear my head. You know what? I'm going to do that. It'll spare me from having to look at all your faces right now anyways, stupid ass. Why is she so rude, bro? Yes, sir. It's my baby. I can't believe she acted like that. You probably hate me now. No. How could anyone have gotten frustrated after being treated like that? You handled it as well as anyone could. I don't think any less of you. Well, alright. I believe you. Thanks. You're too kind. I'm thankful to have you part of this club now. One more thing. That one thing Natsuki said about, you know, I would never do anything so shameful. So, huh? What did she say? Well, never mind. I'm gonna make some tea. Good idea. Make enough for more than one person, okay? Okay, everyone. It's about time for us to leave. How'd you feel about sharing poems? It was a lot of fun. Well, I say it was worth it. It was alright, I guess. How about you? Yeah, I say the same. It was neat thing. It was a neat thing to talk about, everyone. Awesome. In that case, we'll do the same thing tomorrow. Maybe learn something from your friends too. Yeah, let's go. Can't say I'm not enjoying it. About what happened earlier. What do you mean? You know, between Yuri and Natsuki. Does that thing kind of happen often? No. That's really the first time I've seen them fight like that. I promise they're both wonderful people. You don't hate them, do you? No, I don't hate them. I just wanted your opinion, that's all. I can see why they'd make good friends with you. Phew. You know, it's nice that I get to spend time with you in the club. Okay. Every day is gonna be so much fun. This beat is wild. This beat right here reminds me of Pokemon, bro. Like old school Pokemon, like on the DS, on the Game Boys. I just want to get up and dance, bro. These beats go crazy. Alright, this poem gotta be about joy, yup. Here it comes. Ready? Yeah! Oh my god! Friends! Yeah! Loud, hell yeah. Fireworks, hell yeah. Oh, that's new. That's a new whistle right there. I never heard that one. That's a little eerie, I can't even lie. I'm just writing how I feel right now with this music, bro. I'm sorry if I look crazy. I cannot stop dancing. This shit is ridiculous. It should not be this good, bro. It should not be this good, bro. Oh man, I was about to freestyle. I just stopped myself though. That shit was too fire, bruh. Yeah, I've gotten a little more comfortable here over the past few days. Entering the club room, the usual scene greets me. What's up, Sayori? Looks like you're in a good mood today. I'm just still not used to being in a club, that's all. I see. It's a pretty simple thing to get you in a good mood, but I guess it's always a simple thing to you. Anyway, speaking of which, kind of hungry. Oh, will you come with me to buy a snack? Nah. It's not like you at all. I have my reasons. Excuse me. I just wanted you to look at it. Oh. She fumbles with the latch and gets it open. Then she turns it upside down and lets contents spill onto the desk. This bitch only got 2 small coins. I knew it. You want me to pay for it? You dirty scumbag. Ooh, got her ass. It's hard to read when these beats are so good, bro. I give up. Don't make me feel guilty. If you feel guilty, it means you deserve to feel guilty. Aha. Eh? I didn't notice she was even listening. Her face is in her book as always. I wasn't listening or anything. I was just, it was something in my book. Yuri, tell him to let me borrow some money. That's... Don't give me a vibe like that, Sayori. Besides, you should only buy what you can responsibly afford. That is what my dad always told me whenever I would ask him for new toys. That's why he bought me books. I didn't mean that. I just get too absorbed into my book. I really like when you speak in my ear. For whatever reason, I feel like she just talked fast, you know? You are right, though. I did something bad, and I have to accept the revolution. Okay, I ain't gonna lie. That was funny. Oh, man. Don't let her fool you. Sayori knows exactly what she's doing. After all, she told you guys she was bringing me to the club before she even told me. But you wouldn't have come if it wasn't for the cupcakes, so I had to trick Natsuki into making them. Come on, give me more credit than that.
Did I just slap her?
Oh, bruh, I thought I smacked her. It's because I paid my restitution. Retribution. Actually, that one almost worked.
Oh, look at her.
I was just gonna give it to you, but then I heard you blabble about the cupcakes. That was totally worth seeing your reaction, though. Natsuki, that was so not nice of you. I'm so happy. She hugs the cookie. Jeez, nigga, just eat the ding. She went crazy. See? I told y'all she went crazy. I keep looking over here because I'm used to the camera over there. I'm so sorry, y'all. You're going through a lot, just over one cookie.
Babies can't be twisted, my guy.
But yours is chocolate. Yeah, why do you think I gave you that one? Fine. I'm still really happy you shared this one with me. Okay. I get it. Okay, I can't lie. That is hilarious. That is funny as hell. Nah, that is so funny, bro. Monica, can you tell Sayori? Huh?
Monica.
Ugh, where's Monica anyways? Good question. Have you ever heard anything about her being late today? Not me. I haven't either. That's a bit unusual. I hope she's okay. Of course she's okay. She probably just has something to do. She's pretty popular after all. Huh? You don't think she has a... I wouldn't be surprised. She's probably more desirable than any of us all combined. Excuse me? Sorry, I'm super sorry. Ah, there you are. I didn't mean to be late. I hope you guys weren't worried or anything. Monica chooses a club over her boyfriend after all. You're so strong-willed. Boyfriend? What on earth are you even talking about? Ah, never mind that. What held you up anyways? Well, my last period today was study hall. I kind of just started recently. I've always wanted to learn piano. That is so cool. You should play something for us, Monica. That's... Maybe once I get a little bit better, I will. Why does she keep looking at me? She. You know what it is. I didn't mean any pressure or anything like that. Don't worry. I've been practicing a whole lot recently, and I'd really love the chance to share once I'm ready. In that case, best of luck. Thanks. Oh, shit. Okay. Alright, look, y'all. So basically what happened was the shit crashed. I had to reload it. But when I redid the poem, I guess because the poem favored her more than it favored Sayori this time, it brought us here instead of to where Sayori was. Okay, I didn't know the game worked like that, but I'm sorry about that. We back in it. Shit, my bad, y'all. Just curious, how come we have two copies of the same book? Well, when I was stopped by the bookstore yesterday... that's not what I meant. I mean, I just happened to buy two of them. Some are fairly obvious here that Yuri isn't telling me, but I decided to let it go. I'll definitely start reading it again, so I'm glad to hear. Once it starts to pick up, you might have a hard time putting it down. It's a very engaging and relatable story. That's how I feel about this game. Like, this game at first is like, eh... But like once I got into it and like started into the beats, oh my god. The Portrait of Markov. It's an ominous looking eye symbol on the cover. Illuminati. I just wanted to make sure you don't accidentally give anything away. Basically, it's about this girl in high school who moves in with her long lost younger sister. But as soon as she does, her life gets really strange. She gets targeted by these people who escape from a human experiment prison. And while her life is in danger, she needs to desperately choose who to trust. No matter what she does, she ends up destroying most of her relationships, and her life starts to fall apart. That's kind of dark, ain't it? She gently giggles all of a sudden. Are you not a fan of that sort of thing? No, it's not that. I mean, I can definitely enjoy this kind of story, so don't worry. I hope so. I totally forgot she's into this. She's so shy and reclusive on the outside, but her mind seems to be completely different. It's just those kinds of stories, they challenge you to look at life from a strange new perspective. When horrible things happen, not just because someone wants to be evil, but because they have their own goals and their own philosophy they believe in. She is really into books. Like, she is... Yeah, you definitely are rambling. She is really into books. Well, I guess it's alright then. But I feel like I should let you know that I have this problem. When other things like books and writing fill my thoughts, I kind of forget to pay attention to other people, so I'm sorry if I ended up saying something strange. That just means you're passionate about reading. Least I can do is listen. Yeah, see, he's trying to get in them cheeks. He's trying to bust them cakes up. So I'm gonna sit next to her and read books with her. Okay. Yeah, you can see he really shooting for this girl. I want her. Let me know if I'm distracting you, shorty. I realize that she's not actually looking at her own book. She's reading from my book.
Sorry! I was just...
You really apologize a lot, don't you? I don't really mean to. Sorry, I mean... Here, this should work, right? Oh, okay. Look at my boy. Getting it in. Look at him. Oh shit, my boy getting a little horny. My boy getting a little horny. Sorry, I think I got distracted. That's okay, you're not as used to reading right. I don't mind being patient if it takes you a bit longer. Probably the least I can do, since you've been so patient with me. We continue reading. She no longer asks me if I'm ready to turn the page. Instead, I just assume she finished this page before me. We continue the first chapter in silence. Feels like an intimate exchange. Okay. Hey, Yuri. This might be a silly thought, but, the main character reminds me of you. See how her eye looked over? You think so? How? Well, I guess she's more blunt in a lot of ways, but she also second guesses all of the things she says and does. Like she's afraid she'll do something wrong. Reminds me of your mannerisms. She remains silent, but that's probably a terrible thing to have in common with her. I mean, that's so embarrassing you think that. I didn't mean it in a bad way. Sorry, I didn't... I guess I meant more, it's kind of cute. What are you saying all of a sudden? Okay, everybody. Damn. She cock blocking. Damn, Monica. Damn. I guess I don't have too much of a preference either way. In that case, I'll read a bit more tonight. It'll be more fun to read with you after it picks up a bit, you know? That's good reasoning. In that case, feel free to finish the first few chapters in your own time. And he stand up, had to fix himself. And he had to stand up and fix himself. Alright, time out, yo. My bad, yo. I had to take care of something. Who do we go with first? We gonna go with baby girl. Plus, I feel like Monica gonna talk. Monica just be talking too damn much. Alright, let's see what she wrote. Okay. So because my poem was like favorite towards her this time, it like actually changes the story. Ah, she likes me. Yeah, just being appreciated like this, I guess. Probably sounds really stupid, but seeing someone motivated by my writing, it just makes me really happy. Are you saying you never shared your writing before? Really? I don't believe it. I really only write for myself, and besides, people will just laugh at me. Yep. Even your close friends? Anyways, do you wanna share the poem you wrote today? If it's with you. The raccoon. It happened in the dead of the night while I was slicing bread for a guilty snack. My attention was caught by the scuttering of raccoon outside my window. That was, I believe, the first time I noticed my strange tendencies as an unordinary human. I gave the raccoon a piece of bread, my subconscious well aware of the consequences, well aware that a raccoon that is fed will always come back for more. The enticing beauty of my cutting knife was the symptom. My bread and hungry curiosity, the raccoon. Da 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 da, blah blah blah, boop doop da ba da ba ba ba. I can see that, a lot more metaphorical. Yup, I can't begin to imagine what this poem is about. Yes, sir. I literally just had to skip that shit. Using the poem as a canvas to express vivid imagery and conveying emotions through them. I think I have ADHD or some shit like that, bro, because I'm just all into these beats more than I am into what she's talking about. I guess I do. I feel like everyone's a little... Yeah, come on. It was difficult and some things make it uncomfortable. Facts. 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 Next time, let's go say Yori. No, not Suki, cause she mad. She don't wanna do me. What does that have to do with anything? I don't know. Why is girl so damn mean to me? I don't know. Well, let's see. Well, it's not really worse than the last one, but I can't say it's any better either. Phew. What? Phew, what, nigga? Well, anything that isn't a train wreck, I'll take as a win. And I get the feeling you're probably the most critical anyways. Wait, maybe that was a compliment? Glad to see someone recognizes my experience. Well then, keep practicing, maybe you'll be as good as me someday. That, I thought my poem was more like Yuri's, not Sayori's. It's probably just fly away like letting go of a balloon. You could say we each take care of each other in our own way. Whatever it is, I don't get it, but I guess I'm supposed to show you my poem, so here. Amy likes spiders. You know what I heard about Amy? Amy likes spiders. Icky, wriggly, hairy, ugly spiders. That's why I'm not friends with her. Amy has a cute singing voice. What is wrong with this? What is wrong with this girl, bro? Why is she a hater? I ain't reading this bitch ass poem. Not bad, right? I wish it was like a multiple choice game, like in a sense where I could tell her, what the fuck was that poem? That's what I would tell her. What the fuck was that poem, bro? Hello? Oh. I doubt I have to explain it. Sometimes you can explain complicated issues with much simpler analogies, and it helps people realize how stupid they're being. Like, anyone would agree that the subject of this poem is an ignorant jerk. You know people like that? Of course, it's about how everyone thinks my... That doesn't matter. It can be about anything. I wrote it to be easy to relate to. Everyone has some kind of weird hobby or guilty pleasure. Something that you're afraid if people find out they'd make fun of you or think less of you. But that just makes people stupid. Who cares what someone likes? As long as they're not hurting anyone and it makes them happy. I think people really need to learn to respect others for liking weird things. She said her poem was about an unusual hobby of hers. I didn't really get it, but she said something similar to you. That people shouldn't make each other feel insecure about those things. Really? Well, I mean, yours is pretty weird, so I wouldn't doubt that she has some weird hobbies. Not that there's anything wrong with that. She just keep, like, Natsuki, you just, I don't understand her. She just, like, one of those, like, I'ma be mean because I think you cute type of people. It looks like she learned her lesson. Da 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 da. So I look forward to it. Yes, sir. Monica. I'm gonna do Sayori and Monica. I feel like Monica gonna be on some crazy shit. I like this one. It has some nice feelings in it. Still, though, your tone makes it sound like you like yesterday's poem better. I mean, yeah, I guess you caught me. Sometimes you know me a little too well for my own good. Well, don't just try to be nice about it. If I'm doing a bad job, I'd rather hear it. No. I still like this one, I promise. You know, I wouldn't lie to you. Never, ever. What made yesterday's poem so great compared to this one? Well, not very good at figuring out if poems are good or bad, but that's why I just go by my heart. And if it makes me feel things, then it would be a good poem. I don't even know what a bit talking about, man. Dun-dun-dun. Boom-boom-boom. Do-dum-dum. Ba-dum-dum. At least try giving it some thought. You know, that's the least that you could do. Give it some thought. You need to think about yourself once in a while. If you don't, you might end up getting hurt at some point. Well, I don't really know what you mean, but I'll keep it in mind. Well, whatever. Anyways, let's see. I guess I like happy poems. Wait, sometimes I like sad poems too. Sometimes a little bit of both. There's a word for that, right? What's the word I'm looking for? Bittersweet. I like things that are happy and things that are sad. Happy and sad. I can't see liking something that's sad. Well, I like happy the most, but sometimes when you have a little rain cloud over your head, a sad poem can give you... Man. Maybe I'm getting better at expressing my feelings after all. I wanna read your poem. Bottles. I pop off my scalp like the lid of a cookie jar. It's a secret place where I keep all my dreams. Little balls of sunshine all rubbing together like bundles of kittens. I reach inside with my thumb and forefinger and pluck one out. It is warm and tingly, but there's no time to waste. I put it in a bottle to keep it safe. And I put the bottle on a shelf with all the other bottles. Happy thoughts, happy thoughts, happy thoughts. And a bottle all in a row, though. In a row. And it'd be right up motherfucking essay, ain't she? Boom, bada boom. Boom, da da da. Let's go. Yeah, but I mean, I didn't expect something like this coming from you. Like, why did everybody in this shit sound like they like low key dissing each other, bro? Creepy. Well, not exactly. I promise y'all, it's not the game making me yawn. I promise y'all. Thanks. I feel like I was meant to express myself this way. Helps me understand my own feelings a bit better. Writing is like magic. Dun 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 dun. Monica, what's the word? What you got going? What you wanna do? Yawing? As long as it's not going bad, I'm happy that you're applying yourself. Maybe soon you'll come up with a masterpiece. I wouldn't count on that. You never know. I want to share with you what I wrote for today. Okay, sure, here you go. Great job. I was going, oh, in my head while reading it. It's really metaphorical. I'm not sure why, but I didn't expect you to go for something so deep. I guess I underestimated you. It's easiest for me to keep everyone's expectations low. That way it always counts when I put in some effort. Ha, it's not very fair. Well, I guess it worked anyways. You know that Yuri likes this kind of writing, right? Dum dum ba bum bum do do dum da dum dum dee 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 do do dum ba dum bum ba ding ding da dum dum ba dum bum. Dun 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 dun. You do your own thing. Just keep exploring and learning by trying new things. But anyways, you want to read my poem now? I like the way this one turned out, so I hope you do too. Yeah, let's take a look. Save me. The colors, they won't stop. Bright, beautiful colors, flashing, expanding, piercing. Red, green, blue, and endless. Cacophony of meaningless noise. The noise, it won't stop. Violent, grating waveforms, squeaking, screeching, piercing. Sine, cosine, tangent, like playing a chalkboard on a turntable, like playing a vinyl on a pizza crust, an endless poem of meaningless. Load me. Hey, what is up with her, bro? Like, first she had that poem about, like, she thought somebody was looking through a hole just to realize she was on the inside looking through a hole at somebody else. And now she's talking about RGBs and... It's even more abstract than your last one, huh? It's just a kind of thing I've never really seen before, I guess. I kind of like playing with my space on the paper. Choosing where and how spatial words can totally change the mood of the poem. It's like magic. Sometimes asking what a poem about isn't the right question. A poem can mean abstract as a physical expression of feeling or a conversation with the reader. Not every poem is about something. Sometimes you'll find yourself facing a difficult decision. When that happens, don't forget to save your game. You never know when you might change your mind or when something unexpected may happen. See what I'm saying? Like, she's being weird, bro. So just for that alone, yeah. Wait, is this tip even about writing? What am I even talking about? That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening. Yo. I don't know. Sorry I'm not reading. I have a very uneasy feeling about what the fuck. Huh. We're going to keep it simple, okay? We don't need much more than a few decorations. But that doesn't tell us where we're actually going to be for the... I thought you heard about it already. We're going to be performing. Monica. Yeah, we're going to be having a poetry performance. Well, I did. Do you really think it's that bad of an idea? Well, no. It's not a bad idea, but I didn't sign up for this, you know? There's no way I'm going to be performing in front of a group of people like that. I could never in my life do something like that. Imagining it, Yuri shakes her head in fear. Guys, no, Sayori. I understand where they're coming from. Okay. Gotta give it our best shot. I'm sorry, bro. What Monica was saying and doing is like really, it still have me thrown off. That's right. And it's for those reasons that we're all in this club today. Don't you want to share with others to inspire them to find some feelings? Looking at me like she wonderwood. What about you, Yuri? She gonna say yeah. Come on, let's go. Two set on well. Da 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 da. So we have to read our poems out in front of everybody. Okay. The way they fly. Okay, let's see if she knows some weird shit again, bro. Okay. Oh, so it's not gonna actually read it. Okay. Thank you very much. Just hoping this set a good example. Are you ready to go next, Sayori? I'll go next. After image of a crimson eye. Just a moment ago, she practically refused to do this. Why is she suddenly putting in so much effort? As Yuri gets past the first couple of lines, her voice changes. It's almost like what happens when Yuri gets absorbed into her books. Her quivering words transform into the sharp syllables of a fierce and confident woman. The poem is full of twists and turns and a structure that she enunciates with perfect timing. It is weird how like my nigga's starting to talk with like very big words. As we applaud, Yuri holds a poem to her chest and rushes back into her seat. That was really good. Thank you for sharing. Okay, series next. My meadow. Da 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 da. Try not to think of it like you're reciting to other people. Imagine you recite it to yourself, like in front of a mirror in your own head. She begins her poem. Somehow, it feels like her soft voice was made for a perfect match. The poem isn't aimlessly cheery like Sayori is. It's serene and bittersweet. But hearing it come from Sayori's voice almost gives me a whole new meaning. It's like I get to reach more deeply into someone I thought I knew through and through. I did it. Good job. I guess that's a good sign. What does that even mean? Alright, so Natsuki's next, right? Or am I next? Boom. Alright, I'm gonna go next. What's up, then? Yup. I'm not exactly confident in my own writing and try to put energy into it. Despite that, once I finish, I receive applause anyways. Don't worry about it so much. I think it's less about your abilities and more about your lack of confidence in your writing. That's something that'll improve over time, though. Alright then, that just leaves you, Natsuki. Poem is called... Why are y'all looking at me? Because you're presenting. Anyways, the poem is called Jump. These beats are literally just the same beats, but they don't feel like recycled or old, bruh. Well, do you at least feel prepared enough to recite a poem in front of other people? Dum bum. Ding 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 ding. Bum 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 bum. Dun 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 dun. Alright, I know the festival's coming up, but let's try to write poems for tomorrow as well. It's been working out really nicely so far. Monday's a big day, I can't wait. Alright, I stand up. Ready to go, Sayori? Yep. Look, you two always going together like that. It's kind of adorable, isn't it? Jeez, guys, don't make such a big deal of it. It must be a little nice, though. Well, how am I supposed to respond to that? Whatever, let's go already. Ooh. Mmm. Ooh. Eee. Ooh, this is new. It's kind of hard. I like it. I like it. I try to rhyme, but can't think of anything in time, but it's okay. Spent a whole day in a literature club, catching doves, writing poems, going home, with Sayori. Yuri got me horny. Reading that book together, it's so adorning. I mean adorning upon me that I like to read. Okay, look at my sweater. It's like a thing. But what a Lorax. Get the Horbex. What? Don't make sense, but it still rhymes. Oh well. Shit. Commit a crime? I don't know, nigga. I'm just flowing, cause it's beat. It keep owing and going all day long, all night long, and you got a schlong. Wait, pause. Keep going, though. And just keep the flow. Keep it moving, cause these beats, boy, they got me grooving. The whole video, you already know. Watch it from beginning to the end, though. Get the full view. Increase my watch time. Shit. So I can get a dime. Cause that's all that I get from YouTube. They help me, but so do you. I mean, you know, not the fans. I'm talking about you, though. The fake man behind the camera. That's not subscribed. Come on, cuz. It don't even cost a dime. You do it free. For me. So I can keep flowing on these beats, going crazy. I mean brazy. Oops, what? Psych, I meant crazy. Look at these houses, they real nice shit. I bet they real expensive. They don't make sense. Didn't even rhyme. I think it's time to give it up. Okay, let's get on with the motherfucking, motherfucking, bruh. I mean, she fumbles with her words. So let's just say that one day Yuri asked to walk home with you, huh? What would you do? Like, what kind of question is that? You're kind of putting me in a weird spot. I will walk home with Yuri. Oh. I think Sayori likes me, but I like Yuri though. Damn. Damn, that's a tough spot. I want baby girl. I think if one day she asked me, one day wouldn't hurt. You admitted it. Jeez, there's not even any point in speculating. Something's never gonna happen. Well, maybe. But I just like to think about it. It's not long before you won't need me anymore, you know? I need you. She's tripping, bruh. That's weird. Oh my god! Alright. This beat is crazy. Look. Let's see if we can rhyme with the words for a poem. Right? Okay, look. I like this beat. It brings joy. Never mind, this shit is gonna be hard because I'm not a motherfucking rapper. Let's see, unending. Yeah. Haven't sent. Yep. Y'all ready for the breakdown? I literally just listened to this all day, bruh. Not even played a fucking game. Sweet. Oh, I did not mean to put empty. They're bringing back the... Ooh, they crank it up every time. I don't know. Cause Purple looking at me like she want the wood. Oh my god. Oh yeah. How is this pertaining to her? Whatever. I'm not even trying to. Hell yeah, this shit leave me disoriented. Hell yeah. I'll listen to this for eternity. Excitement, hell yeah. The melody. Oh, I did not mean to pick that. Extraordinary. Amazing. Unrestrained. We starting a new day? Okay. Look, y'all. I'm gonna save it right here. This one, yeah. Look. Do do do, blue eyes or red eyes, but green kinda look good. I don't know, cause look at Yuri, she could get the wood. Ooh. Yeah. Oh my god, this is so far. Okay, I appreciate all of y'all for coming out to this new video, cause I know Doki Doki ain't really, you know, the vibe, you know what I mean? Well, to me it's a vibe, but like to y'all it might not be the mood, but I'm telling y'all this game is heat, bro. These beats go crazy, boy. But if you made it this far, I appreciate you, and I hope to see you in the next video. I'll see y'all next time. Adios, y'all. Shit. Bye. Dropped in the concept, falsely accused, misused, and misled, bitch, I'm hoping you fucking rest in peace.